Thank you for tuning in to the Domestic Diva Show. Thank you for listening to this very exciting new rebroadcast of the Domestic Diva Show. Just to give you an idea what to expect from the Domestic Diva Show, because we aren't going to be live. We're going to do some, you know, work online, and we'll let everybody get to see all that, because it's all raw and improv, open mic, freestyle. And probably a lot of things are more coordinated, but not this. And I like it that way. You get to see people for what they're really like, more or less. And we still do the talk show, but it's really a nice atmosphere. And the more help and support we can, acquire, if you will, a lot easier it's going to be able to do this production. Okay. So I started this 10 years ago. And we got to New York, and we were going to turn it into a cooking show, but it didn't go that way, and I'm kind of glad it didn't now. But we had to put it aside for a while. And while that was a tough decision, we're back.
Speak, but did not dare. Something inside was
And welcome back to the Domestic Diva Show, a perfect opportunity to break the ice. Yeah, literally a block of ice. And really, I know how stressed out a lot of people get about performing and theater, and there's a lot of pressure we put on ourselves. So this is a perfect opportunity to start our first episode about breaking the ice, kind of breaking the mold. That's exactly what we're trying to do. There is no pressure. A lot of the pressure we put on ourselves is because of our own expectations. And believe it or not, I think we draw more attention to ourselves when we put ourselves in that situation. So it's just learning how to get comfortable with ourselves. That's why we have radio theater, because it's improv and it's about getting comfortable and getting overcoming some of these things. And it's a couple purposes behind this. This is obviously for the purpose of creativity. We offer a couple ways to illustrate that through dance movement, improv, open mic, freestyle. We open up the platform for anyone. And I've seen a lot of great performances, but doing it on a stage performance in, you know, a small crowd, theater in the park, that's the object behind what we're doing, or, you know, just small projects. But from this point on, we took on 3 projects, and they're going to be small in nature, of course. But if you haven't seen the lineup, look for that. We're pulling a lot of stuff offline, we're putting a lot of stuff that's online, offline, and creating theater. And it's improv. So there's no, like, copyright strikes or anything like that, you know, other than music, but oh well. But what we're trying to do is create theater. And a lot of people are very comfortable with sitting at home. And then there's some people, they just want a project to work on. So what we want to do with our internet online subscribers is we want you to kind of create your own theater and maybe offer video. And if you want to pass along to me, please do that at mossyrosefield@gmail.com. So these 3 projects, what are they? Well, radio theater, number one, in itself is a project. That means like doing background stuff, microphones, and we get a lot of donations. We get a lot of things that we work with or things that we just find that are really cheap online. You know, I got into the whole thing with wanting to create theater, basically with like the lights and the props. And I like all that, but it's a lot of work to haul of it. So we do a lot of things now with cardboard, painting, and a lot of that's just projects. So I want to tell you about the second project, which is Children's Gallery. Now, I have some kids that are working on a gallery. And one of the things about this performance is it's open to the public, but we're going to have one very special night in November. It's called the Second Chance Dance. And it's a fundraiser. And it is to raise money for children with disabilities and give them the night where we can hand the mic to them. And the Second Chance Dance, I tried to do this last year and it did not work. So we're planning way ahead this time. And raising money means selling tickets and having a dance. And I think a lot of people look forward to that big dance, like the night out. We're going to do as much as we can to make that happen. But right now it's just, you know, improv and dancing and just kind of really kind of freestyle. Nothing formal yet, unless something changes, but it's really light, easy, relaxing, and inviting friends and family to the Second Chance Dance. And what it will be is just raffles and dinner or dancing or both. I'm not quite sure. We haven't gotten that far yet, but it is a chance for us to help raise money. And the improv, the microphone, everybody's open to doing whatever, variety show, basically. And that has not been officially scheduled yet, but we're planning it for November. All right, so third, and it's just doing the internet and the work and taking stuff off the internet and taking time to build these projects. I think what I've learned in this is that you don't quit or you don't start a project unless you just keep the projects very small. And that's what I decided to do, is that I wanted to keep it open mic so that everybody has an opportunity to get up on that stage and do a 2 to 3 minute performance, whether it be a poetry reading or play the guitar. I was inspired by a couple of reasons. One, I met Kaylee, this young girl, and I met a lot of kids like this. They're just super talented. And she was out on the street and she was playing for me. And I'm going to put the link below so you can listen to Kaylee yourself. And I mean, it just started to unravel from there. And there's so many young and old talented creative people around me that I honestly wish they had just the stage. And that's what improv is. So they can go up as they please, when they please. They can be still drums. They can do whatever. But a lot of these people that are going to be there also are going to benefit, because by raising money, we're also going to, I'd like to give them money. You know what I mean? I want them to have something to take home with them, or just sense that they earned something. So whether it's in the form of money or a prize, or, you know, everybody's going to find ways to reward good talent, you know? So that's why we're selling the tickets, part of it. Because we want to reward our contestants for this, what I believe will be, hopefully by the time we get to a variety show. All right, and then there's one other project, and that's August, and we're still waiting for the okay on that. And that is just selling coffee. That's what we've been doing, is we sell coffee and we do news. And it's not, again, it's all theater, okay? One of the things I like about what we're planning ahead is that if anyone does volunteer, they can get creative with their apparel. So I expect a lot of things. We have hats. We have a lot of costumes, things like that. So it's really just a one-of-a-kind performance and selling coffee at the same time. And who does this benefit? Well, we want our, like, volunteers to just make people happy. And we know veterans, a lot of them have struggles. We have, like, to visit kids at Children's Hospital who've maybe in the burn unit, to children in rehab or adults with disabilities. And that's the whole point to therapy and dance movement, because this gets everybody out dancing. And if you know anything about dance movement, I hope you learn that there is no set way to dance. And that I love, because there are some people that are just not coordinated or have lost their coordination. Or we would go to another program that we look into is visiting the elderly, the sick, shut-ins, anything. And so we don't want to limit ourselves, you know what I mean? I want us to be able to perform. And I've met some performers just recently, and if you got a chance to listen to my interview, I'm thinking we're going to invite them in on this too, because they do reenactments and etc. So I don't know, it's going somewhere. I'm excited. Again, this is for anyone that wants to do improv, who's comfortable. Maybe they want to do open mic night and they don't want any, you know, structure. That's exactly what it is. Everybody has to take a number and they go up as they come in. And of course, selling the tickets, that means rewarding good talent. So it's just a small project, but it could get big really quickly. So I'd like to keep these things really small. And so we open up with a domestic diva show, and then we take a break, and then we go into radio theater and we do the performance. I like to do the radio part because I think that kind of gets people in the mood to enjoy the night. And there'll be coffee served and hopefully, you know, a small menu or whichever. But however we put this together, hopefully by August and then obviously November, those are the two dates we're shooting for. And the August date is really going to depend, that date is going to depend on a lot of things for final approval. But if we do get the final approval, we may actually schedule more events where we can do more between August and Christmas. So I hope it works. We definitely need your support by doing this. We're obviously drawing more attention to child abuse awareness and all the other things that are going on today, because I think this is a great opportunity for kids who may have been, you know, out there and just don't have anywhere to turn to, an after school project or something like that. We hope to offer that. A lot of parents, they need to send their kids somewhere and they can't afford to send them to, you know, some after school program. But this is another way, if we get that final approval, that we will have an after school program and through a church. And that's initially what we're trying to accomplish, is that this is a big project, and there's a lot of good ideas, but we right now just going to start out as a theater project, and hopefully if it does turn into an after school project, we'll have the funding and all that. There's a lot that went into this, so believe me, I don't have enough volunteers yet to take on much more than I already have. So, and but it looks to me, because we're getting a good response so far, it's gradual. So we got to just get started. That's really where we're at. So it gives us the summer to prepare, and maybe by fall we will have an after school project, and it has to go through some more approvals, and it has to be supervised by a therapist. So there's a lot in front of us. I hope by next school year we'll be up and running, and we will take in kids that their parents are, you know, working, and they can get to us on, you know, to the after school program. Now, for that much, that's what I wanted to do, is take the time, because we are going to be back on air June 1st, but I think we're just going to lay low and just keep doing what we've been doing. One of the shows we have done is called The Court of Public Opinion, and that too is going to be a theater project as well. But I leave everything open to improv now. It's some of the stuff we've done in the past, though, it is already kind of set in stone. But everything's up for variety show and theater, so I look forward to that. And by August, I hope we do accomplish what it is, because that'll mean a lot, and that means fundraising from now to August. Small projects up to that point, but really nothing. We're just doing all fundraising. So we have t-shirts, and we're going to sell pizza and hoagies. And as soon as I get the okay, and then the tough part is getting to know more people in the community and, you know, getting them to help us or doing the fundraising. So that is going to be the interesting part. So I just wanted to give you a chance to get a better idea of the music selection. And the reason we pick an old music is because it is the deja vu program part of it. And if you haven't followed my radio show, you'll know why we do what we do. But I always looked at art and theater and music as a way for people to, you know, just be something different, you know, just be creative. And doing the children's gallery, I'm really excited about that, because the kids are excited. They just drew so many pictures that right now I got a stack of them, and it only took one day to get that stack. So it's gonna be very hard, but we'll probably put them in like photo albums, because they really worked hard at this. So there's a lot of gallery artwork that I'm very proud of, and these kids are just cuties. They want to help the other kids, and that's the whole point to it, is kids help kids. And we have the kids drawing get well cards and all this stuff. So I'm already getting really excited about this, and I just need some people to keep us going, you know. These ideas all could all fade and dry up. All it takes is one big, you know, mess, but we're hoping that we're bigger than that and we're better than that, and who knows, you know. I just want to make sure that what we try to accomplish is that we're not going to bite off more than we chew. We've done that before. It doesn't work out. So doing a small gallery and, you know, doing improv is very easy. It's a lot easier than having to create theater and art and all these fancy projects. And we want to keep it very low budget, because we don't know right now. We don't have a budget, so I got to keep it low budget for now. But if it is funded, then that's a whole nother ball game. Then we can really let the kids get creative. And we're not just dealing with kids. We deal with adults with disabilities. We deal with all types of people in different situations. So When I say kids, I don't want to say that, just kids alone. We deal with elderly. We deal with all people of all ages, of all backgrounds. So this is a chance for people to just have fun and do it in a way that, it's obviously supervised by a therapist or somebody that is in the program of dealing with kids and adults in child abuse recovery. So, and that's the whole point to dance movement. And once you get a better idea of the dance movement and you understand this is all meant for therapy. It's a therapeutic way to have fun, create, do artwork, self-care. Some of the things that a lot of people don't often talk about, which I'm going to go ahead and talk about that now. Now that you know the layout of the radio show, let me tell you about self-care and taking care of yourself, especially for people who have been through a lot. It's really hard to overcome a lot of the things that a lot of people run into. And what I like to illustrate at the Court of Public Opinion, things what we talk about and topics, but aside all those things, because we know how important those things might be to some people, at the end of the day, it's about taking care of yourself. It's about being able to have fun, relax in an environment where you're not stressed out and not so caught up in trying to impress everybody, but just got to be yourself. And that's why part of this is an extracurricular activity, and the other side of it is being able to take care of yourself and have fun again. And for somebody that's been an abuse survivor, having fun is very hard. If you've been from an alcoholic home, or if you've, one of your parents or a friend or somebody very close to you has issues with addiction, finding a natural escape is obviously important. So, even walking, even taking a long walk and just having somebody to talk to. And I rely heavily on a buddy system. So this is an opportunity for people who might be able to meet somebody and have a buddy system and learn to work together. So I hope that gave you enough time to learn more about what we're doing, and we'll add any more information in the description box below. Thank you for tuning in to the Domestic Diva Show here at Planet Radio.
I'm gonna go get some.